Hey guys, this is Jason. Welcome back to my class. For this section, we are going to learn how to export the joins in our design tool. All right, let's just get back to our website. So as you can see in here, after we finish with this floor plan layout, we're going to the joins. So the first one, I want to show you how to export the floor plan joins. So you can click here. So as you can see in here, we just have a plan layout with these textures, colors, dimensions, and these shadows. You know, normally as a designer, we know we will do these works in the Photoshop, you know, add these textures, patterns. So it's very complicated and takes a lot of time, right? But in our floor plan drawings, you can see we have different styles that you can choose to apply these template on your layout, right? So you can see we can choose different styles. And also you can choose different textures on the floor. So it's very convenient for designer to create great floor plan drawings, right? And also you can find different color styles, right? It's very clean and very simple, very nice, right? So as you can also see in here, you can to show the shadow or not, depends on you. Even you can choose with the background color. So it's very easy to create different kind of these floor plan drawings, right? And also you can see on the top, we have some annotation tools if you wanna do some modifications for these dimensions, right? So you can click the annotate, delete useless dimension, or just add some dimensions as you want. Okay, you can see if the drawing is missed with some annotate, you can click the auto annotate and it will generate this dimension and the room information like the name and the area. And also you can add some dimensions if this dimension is not right. Okay, maybe you can click this. And also you can try to use different dimensions like the radius, the linear, and also the wall spacing. So you can try about these dimension tools. And also you can use the text if you want a text like dining area. So, and also you can see we can change some properties for these text or dimensions, like you can choose it. Change a color for this text. And also, you can change the font size. Right, it's very easy. And also, if you wanna add some letter or text, so that's for our basic setting of the floor plan drawings. After that, we can go back to see we have also different size of setting for these floor plan drawings in here. And in the middle is our shuffle, which means it will change the styles randomly. You can choose one as you like. And after you finish all of these settings for the floor plan drawings, you can click HD export. So you can export the files So you can check the picture, right? With this dimension and nice color. So that's the part of the floor plan joints. And let's just go back to our construction joint. So click this one. So as you can see on our left side, you have different views of these construction joints. So first one is our renovation view, which include the plan view and elevation view. You can see here the floor plan. And also the floor plan with the furnitures. So for the decoration view, you can see the whole house with the flooring paving method and with these bricks, the wood. And also you can see the ceiling drawings in here, right? The full roof. And also if you have some custom furnitures, it will show in the custom furniture views, right? So same like the floor plan drawings, we also have some annotation tools on our top. You can see in here. See, if you want to add some dimensions, you can click the linear. Let's see, can just right. Also, you can choose the continue. Yeah, it's very convenient to add some continuous dimension. Double click to cancel. And also, we have different radius and angle annotation for the dimension tools, right? And also, you can tag, add some text and add some symbol like the square, the circle, and arrows on these drawings. So, and also I want to show you with this one, the generate view, which means you can choose some of these So you can see I can use the generate views to choose like one of these elevation, and you can also click here and select the area of this elevation and click view elevation. So you will see from this direction to the wall and window, we will create an elevation here, right? So these are those annotation tools on top of the page, okay? And also you want to choose some joints to go with one on one page. You can go to the joints layout and choose one of these and change the scale of it. I can put in here, right? I can set it like as 40, okay? And also you can choose with floors. Right, and you can change the scale of it. So it's the scale is different, right? And also you can choose from here, it's much more straight to see in here. So So you can choose from the elevation and also for the roof, right? We can just drag and drop in here and change scale. And so also after we download this layout setting, we can just download it. And you can see we have different types of these drawings, like the CAD file, the PDF, the JPEG, and then the mix. Okay, after download this, you can just download it. After you download it, you can make a quick view for this CAD file. I will show you if there is some mistake. So when you open this CAD file, you can see we have different layers for these drawings. So you, and also you can do some modification in the CAD file if you want. Okay. So go back to our class. We have a small assignment for you guys. So after you finish all of these designs, right, you need to export drawings, include four drawings based on the previous design. Okay, first is one of the elevation drawings and one overall floor plan, and also the flooring design plan, and last one ceiling design plan. Okay,